So what happens when you release an entry-level graphics card at the worst time for graphics card launches? Well, you're either the hero or the villain for even trying, and that's kind of what's going on with the latest graphics card from AMD, the Radeon RX 6400. After so long, builders are finally getting a GPU that isn't bulky, overly expensive, and doesn't require extra power. This makes it an interesting option for those on older APU systems, folks wanting to upgrade one of those big box pre-built computers, or even budget new builders. But is it really a good option, and what are folks saying about this little GPU that came to save the entry-level gamer? Well, in this video, I'll round up the reviews so far. So before I discuss what the internet is saying about the Radeon RX 6400, it kind of helps to know what it is. We're talking entry level here, so no massive coolers, no crazy overclocked models, just a simple graphics card trying to do its thing. The RX 6400 is based on the Navi 24 die and made by TSMC on the 6-nanometer node. We're looking at a 768 stream processors operating at a game clock of 2039 MHz. 4 GB of GDDR6 are on board, running at an effective 16 gigabits per second by way of a 64-bit bus that results in a modest 128 gigabytes per second of memory bandwidth. Now that will be aided slightly by the 16 megabytes of Infinity Cache. No external power requirements because of the 53-watt TDP and locked overclocking, so expect quiet, cool, and single-slot cards aplenty. And at a starting MSRP of $159, it's at least in reach of many. But a word of caution, as this is running a PCIe Gen 4 with only 4 lanes, meaning that if you run it on an older PCIe 3.0 system, you're going to be severely cutting into your bandwidth potential. With all of that out of the way, specs mean nothing if they're not throwing down some sweet and fast pixels for games at the intended target resolution. So, what are folks saying about the RX 6400? Honestly, not a whole lot to write about home here. According to Hardware Unboxed, the overall average performance is, at best, on par with the older GTX 1650 and faster than the now ancient GTX 1050 Ti. And if you're running the PCIe Gen 3.0, then expect an average of 10% performance drop over that of a Gen 4 system. But it's not all bad, though. For example, ETA Prime found that this card does indeed fit well into small form factor systems, especially if your target use is going to be older games or emulation, both of which the GPU handled without issue. So there's a place for it, even if it's not blowing anyone's socks off with benchmark numbers. Now, I think OzTalks Hardware summed it up best for how he felt about this graphics card.
To me, I think if you need the low profile, the 6400 is the right one to get. If that doesn't matter to you, then I still think the 6400 isn't a bad choice right now.
He does caveat that by saying that if you can find a GTX 1650 within $10 from the 6400, the 1650 is the better option. And he's right. It's a weird time to be trying to recommend entry-level discrete GPUs with so many factors to consider, but it's at least great to have another option out there. So, what should you do? Well, it really depends on your budget and expectations. If you're only going to be playing mostly free-to-play titles at 1080p or upgrading an aging system that doesn't have a supplemental power for PCIe 6 pin, well, then you might find this one acceptable. It's a great option if you're looking for a low-profile card too, as there aren't too many options available in the market for new ones. But with prices coming back around for the RX 6500 XT only being about $50 more, then I would highly recommend stepping up to that range of graphics cards. Well, what about you? What are your thoughts on the RX 6400? Right on the money or too little, too late? Let us know down in the comment section, and while you're down there, hit that like button and make sure you're subscribed here at PC World for even more PC hardware and software goodness.